After the launch of the British Columbia Provincial Government's website and online survey for the Filipino Cultural Center, Filipino-Canadian lawmaker Mabel Elmore clarified there is no lead group for the project.
At this stage, there's no designated, lead organization. There's not only one organization. The message is really we want to hear from the whole community, the broad community, individuals and organizations.
Elmore was in a recent town hall meeting by the Filipino BC where the group laid out its roadmap to building its own Filipino community center. The roadmap shows that the group is now on its fourth stage, which involves developing a funding strategy from grants, donations, and corporate sponsorship for the group. The group is also conducting its separate survey from that of the government.
It's not just a plan for us to tell people. It's a plan for us to empower the community to know exactly what needs to happen in order to build a community center.
During the forum, Rob Nijar of the Sunset on Fraser Business Association asked if Filipino BC has real support from the Filipino community.
Well, what I would like to hear was that, yes, they have reached out to those organizations and said, we want you to join us and develop a plan together. That's what I want to hear. That's not what we heard.
Nijar, a former provincial lawmaker, explained to Filipino BC that the government tends to shy away from funding cultural projects if it sees signs of a rift in the community.
They get messages, they get phone calls, they get conversations. And when they see there's a rift, they are trying to protect taxpayer money, and they will not give money where it's endangered by rifts.
RJ Aquino refused to give Dijar a clear and definite answer on whether or not he has the backing of the community. For her part, Elmore says 100% agreement within the community is simply unrealistic.
I don't accept that, the expression of that unity is everybody has to agree on everything, right? That's not my expectation, that the community is going to agree on everything, right? Mm-hmm. In terms of the project.
Also in the forum, Filipino BC was asked about its rift with the Mabuhay House Society. Filipino BC member Marina Hamoy admits that she too is confused as to why the two groups are working separately towards the same goal.
If we can focus away from, this personalizing of things, of groups and people, we can move forward actually. This should not be about proving, being able to prove oneself as an organization. This should be about making peace, making an effort to reach out.
Mabuhay House earlier said that it remains open to a dialogue with Filipino BC to address the issue. Aquino assured that he too is willing to talk to them.
I think I've expressed this multiple times in writing, over the phone, that meeting and having a substantive agenda to discuss how we can move forward is something that I am open to having.
Rowena Papasin, ABS-CBN News, Vancouver.